Hi there, it's Professor Monty. Let's look at the discriminant to identify types of solutions. Okay, so if you remember, the quadratic formula looks like this. The discriminant is the stuff under the square root, so it's the b squared minus 4ac. And so let's think about what that tells us. For instance, suppose that that's a zero. Well, if that's a zero, I lose my square root, it goes to zero, I lose the whole plus or minus. I'm only going to get one answer. The answer is just going to be negative b over 2a. So if the discriminant is 0, I get one rational solution. The solution is negative b over 2a, whatever I get here. Now suppose that's positive. If that's a positive number, there's one of two things. Either it's a perfect square. If it's a perfect square, I'm going to take the square root, and I'll get a number. But that number is going to be some whole number. Well, now I've got negative b plus or minus that whole number over 2a. I'm going to end up with two answers. They're both rational numbers because the square root has disappeared once I took the square root. Okay, so if I get a positive discriminant and it's a perfect square, I get two rational solutions. Now, I put a note here. If that happens and that was a perfect square, I could have factored the original problem. I didn't have to do anything else in order to solve, but it's going to be factorable. It factors. Now, if that number is not a perfect square, then I've got the square root of some number that I can't simplify. It's an irrational number. But because of the plus or minus, I'm going to get two answers. They're both irrational. So if the number under there is positive, but it's not a perfect square, I get two irrational solutions. If that number is a negative number, it's a complex number. And I'm going to get two answers because of the plus or minus, so I get two complex solutions. And what I've said here, I put a little star here. Well, the star says for these two types of things, if I'm going to get two irrational solutions or two complex solutions, I should use either the quadratic formula or completing the square to solve the equation. Okay, and let's just look at an example of how I would use this. So I've got a quadratic equation here. It says identify the number of types of solutions. Well, I'm just going to use the discriminant. I'm going to say, okay, let's look at b squared minus 4ac. Now remember, a is 2, b is 7, and c is negative 3 in this case. So that a, b, and c are the ax squared plus bx plus c. Make sure that's a zero before you figure out what C is or any of the other numbers. Make sure these are in the proper descending powers of X. And then A is the X squared term, B is the X term, C is the constant term. So now when I plug these in, I get B squared, which is 7 squared, minus 4 times A, which is 2, times C, which is negative 3. So I get 49. Let's see, negative 4 times 2 is negative 8. Times negative 3 is positive 24. Let's see. So that's 73. Okay, so now I go to my chart. What does that mean if I get a 73 on there? Well, it's positive, so I'm going to get two answers. I don't know the square root of 73. It's not a perfect square, so I'm going to get two answers, but they're both irrational. It fits in right here. Oh, the discriminant is positive, not a perfect square, two irrational solutions. So if I want to solve that, I can't solve by factoring. I could use the quadratic formula. I could use completing the square. This would be best to use the quadratic formula. It's not set up nicely to do completing the square. But the discriminant tells me right away how to do that. And so that's its purpose. That's its use. Sometimes it'll help you identify how to solve, or at least the type of solutions you would expect to get.